What is a success and what is a failure? You know, our scholars, when they discuss this question of success and failure, they said if you examine human being inside, each and every individual, we are made up of two major attributes. I want to please kindly pay attention. It's very simple. It's not something complicated. We are made up of two major attributes. The one they call sifatu wa kiyya, and the second one sifatu nafsiya. What is sifatu wa kiyya? Simple English translation: actual attributes. And then the second one is psychological attributes. So success and failure, they are psychological attributes. I need to pay attention to them to understand. Hence, our scholars, when they were asked, what is the definition of a success? Look at what they said. Ibaratun al-ladhatin aqliya. They said it refers to intellectual entertainment. What is intellectual entertainment? They said it's opposite sensory entertainment or sensory feeling, if you like. I give an example. Say a person is very thirsty. You know, the weather is too hot. You exhausted from work. So you come back home, someone offers you a glass of cold water or a glass of orange juice. When you drink, how do you feel? You feel good. But question, how long does it last? 2 hours? It will not even reach 2 hours. You will forget. That is sensory enjoyment. But say, for instance, you're really looking for some mas'ala, something you don't understand in Islam, or even at your studies, at work. You trying to explore different avenues to understand it. You contact that Maulana or that scholar. It takes you long, but eventually you discover the truth. How do you feel? You feel good. That's success. What I'm trying to say is that success doesn't come cheap. It comes with efforts. Hence, Quran makes it very clear. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّكُمْ سُبُلَنَا وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَمَعَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah said, indeed, those who strive in our way, we will guide them towards our way. To be spiritual, mu'mineen and mu'minat, to be God-loving, to be connected with Allah, you need to wake up in that coldness weather to pray your fajr. You need to drive from your home to come to the mosque. That's why they said, to be successful, you have to ignore taste for a taste. What taste? Ignore temporary taste for permanent taste. What is temporary taste? Dunya. Permanent taste is when you connect with Allah. To become spiritual doesn't mean you become an unusual person. Wallahi, if you become spiritual, you will enjoy the essence of creation. Quran makes it very clear. Each and every individual is of his own spiritual status. What is important is just to make the effort. Keep determining. Keep making the effort. Quran is saying, Ya ayyuhal insan, innaka kadihun ila rabbika kadahan famula. My point is, rabbika said, oh insan, you are forever toiling towards your Lord. Underline, towards your Lord. Meaning, you are of your own spiritual status. I am of my own spiritual status. What Allah wants to see is that we compete with one another in seeking and yearning for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They said the strongest instinct in every human being is the instinct of love for life. Who doesn't love life? The more money we make, the more we want to make. We love life. Who want to die? Only people, when they get overwhelmed by troubles, by problems, forgetting Allah, that's the time to say, no, better I go. But otherwise, we all love life. And that is the nature of insan. But what is beautiful about Quran, and I want especially the youngsters to pay attention to this. Quran beautifully comes forward and say that each and every individual, depending on your age, express your love for life differently.
Quran 57 verse 20, Suratul Hadid.
You know what does Allah say?
Wa'lamu annama al-hayatu ad-dunya la'ibun wa la'un wa zinatun wa tafakhurun baynakum wa takafurun fil amwali wal awlad.
Stop there. I'm going to dissect this properly to understand what is a real success and what is a fake success and what you should fight for in your lives.
Dunya is nothing number one but sports. Sport here doesn't mean football, whatever I'll explain to you. And then he says play, number two. And number three, he said beauty. And number four, he said rivalry. And number five, he said vying in multiplication of wealth and children. Now, when Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is spelling out all this as definition of dunya, Allah is trying to tell us, each and every one of us has a way of expressing his love for dunya. Let's begin number one. Innama al-hayatu dunya la'ibun. I want to go direct translation. Indeed, the life of dunya is a play. Allah is not saying all of us, we express our love for dunya by playing. It's referring to children up until 7 years of age. Children up until 7 years of age, they express their love for life by playing. You go to our homes where we have children. They've got small room where they've got all their playing stuff there. You take them to shopping mall. That's what they do. That is what psychologists mentioned. When children are up to seven, let them be. Let them play. Because if you do not let them be, you will kill their confidence. That's how they expect their love for life. Second one, Allah said, Walahun. What is lahun? Amusement. What is amusement? To consider what is primary, secondary, and what is secondary, primary. Who expressed their love for life by lahun? It's not children of 7 years. These are teens, teenagers. Teenagers. If you have a teenager in your house, sometimes you're telling her, Baba, this is the right. No, Baba, I want this. You seeing this as a primary thing, your child seeing it as something secondary. Or what you see secondary, the child sees is primary. This is how they express their love for life. Third one, Allah said, Zina, beauty. Who expressed their love for dunya by this beauty? These are people 20 and above 20. Those of 20 years of age, they want Timberland, they want the, this is not by coincidence, eh? This is the nature of the person. 20, 21, 25, that's how they express their love for life. They want something beautiful. Then Allah goes for it. I want you please pay attention. He said, وَتَفَاخُرٌ بَيْنَكُمْ Allahu Akbar. And mutual rivalry. We compete. Which age? Up until 40. This one, I want to say I'm the best. That one said I'm the best. That's how we express our love for life. Mutual rivalry. We compete in every day. We go to school on campuses. We compete. Even if I wear my shoe, I want to compete with the shoe that you wear. If I wear my clothes, I want to compete. Allah said the last one, وَتَكَاثُرٌ فِي الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَوْلَادِ Vying in multiplication of wealth and children. This is how after 40 up until Azrael comes express their love for life. That's why our parents, when he sit here, his child come and mashallah, he said, Mercy, I feel good. Sheikh, that's my son. That's my son. That's my son. He feel good. And you look at it, bank account, alhamdulillah, at my age, Sheikh. Shukri Khuda. I don't want to complain to Izzuman Tasha. But you know, our fathers, they like that. Because at that age, after 40, what else do you want? You only look at your children and what you worked hard for it. So that's how our fathers, when they see, I've got three children, they're accomplished. That one said, I've got one child, is accomplished. That one said, I've got that company. That one said, I've got that foundation. That one said, no, I supported that mosque. That one said, I supported that organization. Our parents is how they express their love for life.
But you know why? When they reach 40, a person starts to sense danger. Whether he will make another 40 or not. Allah,
after 40, it's not easy to get another 40. It's not a joke. After 40, to go another 40, wallah, it's not easy. I give you by 60, Azrael will start knocking. When I reach 40, and I've got all this, people start to transfer into the names of their children. They make will, family will. Listen very carefully, please. I've got the money. I've got these 2-3 houses. I may go. Let him put it in the name of family foundation. Family name. My son's name. You know why? Because insan is thinking that when he dies, his name will still continue. Because I know if I go to Barza, that name will continue. Kimji Foundation, Nanji Foundation. What? How am I doing this? I know I'm going to Barza, but I know the name will continue. It's good. You know why insan does that? Because insan is thinking that that is a success. I've done it in this world. I'm going to Kiyama. I leave it behind also. I am accomplished. I am successful. Allahu Akbar. Quran comes forward and tells us that is a fake success. It's not a real success. Allahu Akbar. Oh, I'm a professor, so I wrote so many books. I'm going legacy. Quran comes forward and said that is a fake success. I built so much mansions. I've got this concept. Yeah, it's a success, but fake. Where do we get that done from? Fake. Surah Ali Imran, verse 14. Zuyyina lin-nasi hubbu ash-shahawati min an-nisa wal-banina wal-kanatir al-muqantara min adh-dhahabi wal-fidda wal-khayl al-musawwamati wal-arham dhalika mata'u al-hayati ad-dunya. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is telling us we made it beautiful for them. Hubbu ash-shahawati min an-nisa, the love of women. Wal-banina, and the love of children. Wal-kanatir al-muqantara, and the treasures of this world, from the gold, from the silver, we made it seemingly beautiful to them. But Allah said, don't worry, dhalika mata'ul hayati dunya. These are all enjoyment of this world, but the best success is with Allah. That's why one ayah said, la yaghurrannaka takalluba alladhina kafaru fil bilad mata'un kaleel thumma ma'wahum jahannam wa bisal masir. Don't be so amazed when you see a person having dunya and doing as he or she please. Allah said, this is mata'un qalil. This is something small. Ending belongs to Allah. Wallah, don't be amazed. Somebody has it, arrogant, chilling, enjoying. Don't worry. You try connecting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But now, if these are fake success, brothers and sisters, young and old, what is a real success? A real success is what Allah mentioned in Quran. فَلَنُوحِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبًا. Allah said, indeed, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٍ. Whoever does a salih, good deed, a male or a female, and they are true believers, Allah said, wallah, we will grant them good living. Question, what is good living? Is it to live in a big mansion? No. I always tell people, if you want to see how insan is miskin of miskin, you have a big house. At night, you go in one small corner and sleep. You don't divide yourself. That's insan for you. That's insan for you. We are limited by time. We are limited by space. So hayatun tayyiba is what? When Allah said, we'll grant them good living. Good living is istiqrar wal itma'inan an-nafs. Good living and real success is sukoon and peace of mind. Allah, today there is no peace of mind in the world. And those who are in trouble are those who have amassed the entire world of this world. Wallah, you go people, they don't even have jobs, but when they go to bed, they sleep. But there are people who got tens and thousands of world, they can't sleep at night. Good living is al-itminan, peace of mind. Today you find some of our youth confused. They can't decide in their lives. They try this, they stop. They try that, they stop. They try that, they stop. I said, Baba, come back to Allah. Allah will guide you. You know what that last is? Allah said, "Man a'arada an dhikri, fa inna lahu ma'ishatan danaka." Whoever ignore my remembrance, that person should be ready for difficult life. So in other words, if you want to have a good life, a good living in the eye of Allah, you have to do remembrance of Allah. So whatever you do in life, do not forget these points. Whether you are a businessman, or you are a student, or you are an Islamic scholar, or any other scholar, the bottom line is whatever you do has to lead you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If whatever you do not lead you to Allah, then Islam doesn't regard it as fruitful.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم إني أسألك وأتوجه إليك بنبيك نبي الرحمة محمد صلى الله عليه وآله يا أبا القاسم يا رسول الله يا إمام الرحمة يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا الحسن يا أمير المؤمنين يا علي بن أبي طالب يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا فاطمة الزهراء يا بنت محمد يا قرة عين الرسول يا سيدتنا ومولاتنا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيهة عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا محمد يا حسن بن علي أيها المجتبى يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا عبد الله يا حسين بن علي أيها الشهيد يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا الحسن يا علي ابن الحسين يا زين العابدين يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا جعفر يا محمد بن علي أيها الباقر يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجتنا يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا عبد الله يا جعفر بن محمد أيها الصادق يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا الحسن يا موسى بن جعفر أيها الكاظم يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجتنا يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا الحسن يا علي بن موسى أيها الرضا يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجتنا يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا جعفر يا محمد بن علي أيها التقي الجواد يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجتنا يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا الحسن يا علي بن محمد أيها الهادي النقي ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجتنا يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا محمد يا حسن بن علي أيها الزكي العسكري ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا وصي الحسن والخلفاء الحجة أيها القائم المنتظر المهدي ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله حاجات. يا سادتي ومواليا إني توجهت بكم عمتي وعدتي ليوم فقري وحاجتي إلى الله وتوسلت بكم إلى الله واستشفعت بكم إلى الله فاشفعوا لي عند الله واستنقذوني من ذنوبي عند الله فإنكم وسيلتي إلى الله وبحبكم وبقربكم أرجو نجاة من الله فكونوا عند الله رجائي يا سادتي يا أولياء الله سل الله عليهم أجمعين ولعن الله أعداء الله الظالمين من الأولين والآخرين آمين رب العالمين.